Hello, Klaus here with a super quick update video all about the new DaVinci Resolve 17.4 update. And as you see from the screen, if you are on a Mac 1 Pro or a Mac 1 Max, DaVinci Resolve has just become 5 times faster. I'm not sure that is the case for us on PC, but for the Mac guys, congratulations. But anyway, let's just jump into DaVinci Resolve and have a look at some of the new stuff. Let's get right to it.
So first off, actually, there is a easy way to manage your colors. So let's have a look at that. So if we go down here and click the wrench and go to color management and change our color science to Black Magic URGB color management, we have now automatic color management. We have 2 different color processing methods, SDR or HDR. So that making thing pretty darn easy to work with. And also the output color space has been limited to the most recently or the most used or common ones, which is in this case Direct 709. So of course, if the color management isn't good enough, you can take off the automatic here and open up all of the color spaces yet again. But this is a super easy and very quick way to actually manage your colors when working in DaVinci Resolve. I'm just going to save and keep that.
Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and one of the new features in DaVinci Resolve is actually a little fun feature if you're doing video transitions. So let's just do a video transition here. Let's just take something I would never use, for instance, the arrow. I'm going to put that in between 2 clips. And before, you only had the option to make it longer or shorter, and the same on both sides. But with the new update, if you push Control and drag, you can make it shorter on the one side and longer on the other. Just like you want it to be. So we do a transition like this instead. Lovely indeed. So that is the first thing I think is a nice little detail. If we go to the next thing, it's actually something about composite modes. So we go up to the inspector, we'll find our composite mode. And what you can do with the composite mode now is you can hover over, and it's going to preview your composite, which I think is a very nice feature, and it's going to make things way faster when working with composite modes, just like in the previous update when they made it possible to do the same with fonts. Lovely addition to this new version of DaVinci Resolve. And of course, like before, you can still change the opacity when you've done your selected composite mode. Pretty nice, pretty darn cool. So if we go further along, there's also been some improvements into the subtitles. I'm going to take a subtitle here and put that on my clip here. So now it's going to give me a subtitle track. So I'm going to take my subtitle here. I'm going to select that, and I'll go up to the inspector, and I'll go into the styles. And for instance, before, if you wanted to add a black background or black box, you could do that, but you had to go in and customize the outline and the corner and all of these things. For instance, I'll go back to captation. For instance, if you started to type, it wouldn't follow the text, but it does this right now. So for instance, if I add in a new, it's already there. And you know, I can continue to write my text. I think this is a great feature, and it's going to make subtitles way more easy to actually do by yourself inside of DaVinci Resolve. Again, I'm going to kill off my subtitles here, and I'm going to delete the layer here. Okay, let's go to the next thing I find very nice. So in the previous update, there were a update to our open effects gear. So I'm going to show you some new stuff here. I'm just going to write key. So here we have our 3D gear. So some of the new features in this is actually, let's turn this off, like that. And I'll go into the inspector. And I'm going to make sure that I have my OpenFX overlay selected. So I'm going to do that. And I'll go into the effects. And I would do what I usually would do, just do a line to do the cut. And I, as you see right now, it's going to show me my the selection. So when I let go, we are going to have that here as we would expect. But of course, you can see that either we could do another stroke to take out the green here, which you might want to do, or you could go and use the despill. And the despill this time is actually, it has more like a slider, so you can push the despill to take out that harsh green despill that was on the footage. And right out of the bat, it's not perfect, but it's a pretty fast and rough key, so it might be okay. And still, we have a ton of new features, such as key adjustments, where we can go in and change stuff around. We also have the matte finesse, which again are going to let us change what we did in the matte and do some finessing with the clean black and clean white. Also, we could add in a garbage matte like we have done before, but for this clip, we aren't going to do that. I just think that this is such an improvement in DaVinci Resolve according to making green screens. So before, if I wanted to do a green screen which were decent, I would have to go to the color page or into Fusion. But now I can do this directly from the edit page. And I think that is just quite amazing that Blackmagic keep improving these things. I would love to see a function where we could add mask into our clips easier than we have to do right now, but I'm sure that's going to come in a near future. So let's jump to the next thing here. So there's been a nice improvement in the way DaVinci Resolve is actually rendering out stuff to YouTube if you do it with the YouTube preset, but also if you do marks. So for instance, I'm going to put in a bunch of marks here on my video. Let's say I want to go to the delivery tab and I want to deliver out my video here. Yeah, put in an in and an out point. So I'll go over to the presets of YouTube and, you know, write the stuff I usually would do. This is the new feature. So when I'm uploading directly to YouTube, I have now the possibility to use my markers as chapters. So if I just push right here, I'm going to use the blue marks I just did as chapters on YouTube, which is going to make things a lot easier when doing descriptions and stuff like that on YouTube. Nice feature, just love it. And since we are here in the export settings, there's also the ability now to render your stuff directly to Dropbox. So if you're working on a project and you need to have some feedback, you can actually render it directly to Dropbox and receive the feedback you need to finish the project. Again, a super nice feature, I think. So if we go to the next thing here, actually we'll go for the color page for this one. So let's say I'm going to go to my open library. I'm going to search for a face refinement. I'm going to add that in. So one of the other features is actually that the DaVinci Resolve Nail Engine is now 4 times faster than before. And this just means that we are now going to be able to do these effects in real time, as you see right now. And this is again going to be a time saver when doing, for instance, the face refinement tool, the beauty plugins, stuff like that. Super nice, super, super great. addition. Okay, so for the next little thing, I'm going to go up to clips here. I'll go to the next one here. I'm going to take off the face refinement because I don't need that. So one thing we all love doing in our clips is actually putting in masks. So let's just add in a mask. I'm just going to do a circular mask here and put this on the hat. Maybe that's what we want to track. That should be fine enough. So before, when we did use the tracker, you could track forward and backwards, and sometimes you had to track from the middle of the clip to the end, and then you had to go all the way from the end and back. But now we have a new button in the tracker, and this is actually just going to track from the point you are in your timeline to the end. And when it's tracked to the end, it's going to jump to that point where you started and track the rest. Again, a super clever way of making tracking inside of DaVinci Resolve 17. Also, there's a couple of new plugins like the custom mixer and stuff like that in the color page. But we're not going to look into that today. That is for another video. Also, there's a ton of new updates to Fairlight. I'm not going to go into that in this video either, but just letting you know that they are thinking about the audio portion of DaVinci Resolve as well. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.